task force projek perumahan swasta sakit dan terbengkalai. Okay, setakat ini, everyone knows that since I was given the task to work with in KPKT, together with Dato KSU, we have set up a special task force. Okay, led by our deputy minister. Before that was YB Akma, now is Dato Aiman. Okay, di mana kita setakat ini, pada pagi ini, telah pun menyelesaikan, berjaya pulihkan 704 projek. Projek-projek yang sakit terbengkarai yang saya warisi dari dulu. Ya? Di mana jumlah GDP adalah sangat tinggi, 58.94 bilion. Tapi yang lebih penting, mungkin kamu tanya berapa orang pembeli rumah yang telah berjaya kita selamatkan. Dia melepasi 80,000. More than 80,000 home buyers finally see the lights at the end of the tunnel. This is very, very important. It will be a game changer for the country's city landscape. Pertama, rang undang-undang pembaharuan semula pandang. Okay? Iaitu Urban Redevelopment, Urban Renewal Act. Hopefully, insyaAllah, 2025. Okay? Di mana kita sedang giat, already garis panduan sudah diluluskan oleh Jemaah Menteri. Okay, mengapa perlukan pembaharuan akta ini? Sekarang ada kekangan. Saya bagi contoh. Dekat KL, banyak flat yang sangat buruk dan dive. Always appear in your paper. Right? Tapi, our hands are tight. Kami tak mampu untuk bina semula. Kerana akta yang sekarang yang ada, Akta 757, Section 57, okay, kurungan 6, said that you have to get 100% consent threshold before you can be allowed to rebuild the building. Saya bagi contoh, dekat satu bangunan kondo, 500 unit, 499 pemilik setuju untuk bina semula, satu orang tak mau, tak boleh lah. So do you think it's fair? Do you think that fellow's interest prevail over other 499.9%? But this is exactly what is happening now. Right? Sebab itu, Kementerian KPKT dah buat kajian demi kajian. We do the best comparative studies with Hong Kong, Shanghai, Tokyo, New York and the rest. We found out that the highest consent threshold under urban renewal, okay, the highest is Singapore. Any building below 10 years old is 90% consent threshold. Any building above 30 years is 80% threshold. Whereas for Tokyo, it's only 60%. Shanghai, two-third majorities. Okay? Only Malaysia, 100%. This makes the entire cities all dilapidated. Okay, yang kedua, rang undang-undang sewaan kediaman. RTA, Rent Tenancy Agreement Act. Sekarang, ramai pun dah mengadu. Okay, ada juga sewa, okay, sewa kutip tapi renovation, macam-macam isu lah. But there's no specific act to protect the tenant as well as the owner. Okay, let me be fair. This ministry, we don't side anybody. I'm sitting here in the middle, always listen to both sides. Everybody's. We listen. Okay, KPKT has a three open policy. What is the three open policy? Open door. Okay, open mind, open heart. We listen. Okay, that's why after meeting you now, I'm going to see Maria, the Malaysia Strategic Alliance for Circular Economy, plastic manufacturers. They are coming to see me at 11 o'clock. We meet everyone. I'll give you an example. Saya jumpa Reda, Pemaju Perumahan. Okay, besok saya jumpa HBA, Home Buyer Association. Walaupun dua-dua gaduh, tapi bagi saya, I duduk tengah-tengah sebagai hakim. We just want to be fair. Okay, let us be fair. The word fair is very important.